the one, that Monday topic. Then Tuesday topic. The covenant keeping God, that God has been so faithful, keeping covenant with us in this house. Then the three, the unshakable shaker. He has been shaking people on our behalf and shaking situations. Then the four, the fulfilling God, he has been fulfilling. Many of us became in trouble, dejected, in despair. But many testimony, some people come to me, many I can't count. But when they came here, God started changing situation. Some of them will say that it's not that I've been settled, but somehow anytime I come here, I feel this kind of comfort and reassurance that it shall be well. And the spirit that is making it, if somebody, if one person, two people, 50 people are saying the same thing, then that spirit that is making people to be comforted is in the house. We praise God for that. On this seventh day, we are going to be talking about the God of increase. The God of increase. It's going to be very brief because of our time. The God of wisdom for the announcements is the God of increase. In this house, God has been increasing us. In the book of Haggai chapter 2 that we have been reading, 2, 5 to 9, we have been considering this portion since Monday that we started. Haggai 2, 5 to 9. According to the word that I covenanted with you when ye came out of Egypt, so my spirit remained among you, fear ye not. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all nations. And the desire of all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, and the gold is mine, saith the Lord of hosts. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, saith the Lord of hosts. And in this KRP, this place, will I give peace.
Amen.
Say the Lord of hosts.
Amen.
Praise God. The God of increase. Why are we rejoicing on this 8th year anniversary? God has been increasing us. You have heard that we started with less than 15 people. 15 people. The task seems so enormous. How will 15 people grow in church? Even if you put them and make all of them head of department, there will still be some department that will have nobody who will not be their assistant. But God has been increasing us. He's our God of increase. From 15, we move to 15, we move to 100, 200, 300, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900. Sometimes we clock 1,000. We just heard of the church that we made provision for. We ran out of it. Who has been doing it is God. That's why we are thanking him and praising him on a day like this. He has been increasing us. Not because there were no challenges. There were some challenges along the way. There is no human being, no matter how anointed or gifted you are in life, that there won't be challenges. But the challenges are not to crumble you. They will even make you better. Even in the midst of the challenges, God has been increasing us. Just like he did for the Israelites in the book of Exodus chapter 1 verse 12. Exodus chapter 1 verse 12. We also said that they were afflicting them. That affliction was supposed to reduce them. But God was multiplying them. In the middle of challenges, they were getting better. Are you going to any form of challenge in this place? I prophesy to you that before the end of this month, you will have been far better.
Amen.
But the more they afflicted them, the more they multiplied and grew. And they were grieved. Because of the children of it, they did not understand. We are trying to destroy these people, but they kept on multiplying. Whenever you see a situation like that, it must be God. It must be God. In the book of Psalm 118, verse 23. Psalm 118, verse 23. David says something. Anytime you see something so marvelous and you cannot truly explain it, just know that it is the Lord's doing. And it is marvelous how in Acts 1:23. One of the first challenges that I remember when we came into this place 8 years ago, was during the inauguration, you know, in the course of the week, we told some stories of some of the things that happened during the inauguration. And I was given the opportunity to make the announcement. As they normally do, the pastor that will be in charge of that place will be told to make the announcement so that you encourage people to come and tell them the services that will be held in that place. So when we made the announcement, and one of the announcements we made was that the people that have been posted to this place from some other area, because some other areas are supposed to supply 2 workers each or something like that, so that it will form, we were supposed to start with 30 people. But the people that were sent here, they refused to come. When they saw the way the place was at the original time, it was not attractive to them. So I made the announcement, please, the people that have been, the place was filled during the inauguration. So I was expecting that they would be around. So few people that came, I think there were about 4 or 5 people that came and met with me. So I'm not trying to tell them that we are going to be starting service, so please, let's be encouraged, let's be around. One of them happened to be a sister from an area headquarter in East Fester. She was posted here. By the time I finished saying what I was saying, he just smiled. I didn't know that within her, she was saying, don't be me and you for this place. Because, you know, we will be seeing the roof, the wooden, the fluorescent light that was in this place. We didn't have windows that time. The TV, for real. Even the fans, we didn't have at that inauguration time, per se. And this place was like any other house that you are seeing there, minus the fact that it was just covered. So she just ate, and that was the last time she came. But God had told me, never ask anybody or beg anybody to join. I will be bringing the people myself that I will use and I will bless. So I remember that she left. But one miracle that we are seeing that God has been increasing on, while she was living in that same inauguration service, one guy walked to me. Said, Pastor, I never saw him before. Said, Pastor, I was in this inauguration service and I think I would like to be part of this parish that you are a pastor. But that one, you know, he didn't know, I didn't know him before. He said, I just feel that I will be part of this parish. And I can play keyboard. Wow. I didn't even know how to get keyboards. How to get, the instrument were just there. You know, some parishes, you will be there for a while before they not start getting people. I can play keyboard and I will organize people that will come for the drum. I was thinking that when people say different things at the beginning of the thing, it's performance that is most important. But true to this brother, he started coming and he was running our keyboard. He will organize people, they will come, some of his friends, you know, they will come, they will play, we will have special program. One guy that told him that I want to give you something. Don't mind, you know, we are starting, we are very rich. He just might say, you want to give me something? He don't need to give me anything. I am happy doing what I'm doing. So that you can give the guys that I have brought. And that was how that guy was operating with us. I didn't know him. The Bible said that nobody can come except my father. So I would be a fool to think that things are happening because of charisma or whatever thing. It is God that has been increasing us. And he started increasing us from when we were disadvantaged. Even in the midst of some people leaving, he brought other people. That is why I have made it in my mind that regardless of who leaves me, not just church setting, in business, in anything, it doesn't matter, God will bring better people. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 1, 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 1, God was telling Samuel, why are you mourning over Saul? I rejected him. Don't you know that for everybody that lives, I have a better person that I have provided for you. Look up and I will send the person. And the Lord said unto Samuel, how long will thou mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? Feed thy horn with oil and go. I will send thee to Jesse, the Bethlehemite. For I have provided me a king among his sons. It was God that provided the king. So God has been bringing people. Even in the midst of that adversity of where not much, God started working. We didn't have an evangelism department for the first two we had, but it was not really operational. For the first 2-3 years, we don't even have an evangelism bus. How many people can say that we are the one coming first time for King Suya Pala? How many times do you see people like you see some people around come to our church for any favor? But we don't do that yet. God has been increasing us. Can somebody say thank you, Jesus?
Thank you, Jesus.
That is why we are thanking God on the day like this. God has made me to realize that once you do my will, forget the rest. I will be doing what you cannot do. And I've been bringing people by himself. In the book of Esther chapter 4 verse 14, Mordecai was telling Esther that in case you think that without you, this deliverance that God has already planned for the Jews will not come. That if you refuse to do anything that God is laying your heart to do, God will raise another person to do. I was telling you of a particular sister that came to us, I think in that year one or year two, that he was looking at one flower. We used to have one half of the flower like this in this place, to keep Nigeria one. And the sister said that they come to my heart, that let me change this thing. God will finish it to her. Yeah, I will do the next one. The next thing, she just saw that the thing had been done with glorious flash. No, to my office. That's the pastor who did that. And he was, I said, sister, what somebody blows. He said, can I go and bring my own? It's too late. Don't worry. Next time when God tells you to do something, he has other options. He has other people that he can use. That is why it has entered into me. I don't look at anybody as my supporter. He just goes. I appreciate people that do anything for me, but if God is laying it, if somebody has to do something and the person refuses to do, I am enough spiritual saying that God will raise another person. What it is in the mind of God is that anyhow it shall be done. He was telling me in that Esther chapter 4, verse 14, let me read it. Esther chapter 4. If thou altogether ordered thy peace at this time, then shall their enlargement and deliverance arise to the Jews from where? Another place. But thou and thy father's house shall be destroyed. And who knoweth whether thou art come to the kingdom for such a time as this? And told her that whenever God is leading you to do something, he will always lead you higher. By the time you do it, you will never remain on that same level. But when you refuse to do it, you are changing yourself. And God will always find a substitute. And the substitute will always be better. That's why I know that for anyone that decides to leave me in whatever area of my life, better persons will be coming. He said that they will come against you one way, but in 7 ways, I will choose them. 7 times better. I always have that mentality, and that's what I've been experiencing in my own life. In the book of 1 John chapter 2, verse 19. This scripture is one of my favorite scripture concerning anyone that decides to leave me for anything, whether in business, in any kind of relationship. They went out of us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were what? They were not all of us. Why are we thanking God? In the midst of the adversity of smallness, God has been increasing us. Let somebody say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
The last thing that I remember very early was about the issue of our generator. The first generator we had is like this perfect grinding generator. You'll be winding it. You wind it to a particular oscillation. You now turn something like, if you refuse to turn it at the time that the engine is supposed to move, if you put, you have to start again. It was manual. Pastor Bill knew how to start that generator more than me. I had to use time to tell him that, you know, me, I will go and fish. Let me go and be preparing and go. Because, something. But God has been increasing us. From there, he gave us the 50 kV generator. At the 11th month, to power the AC. I was telling us that at the second month, this church became air conditioned. My father in the Lord, Pastor Bob, he used to. He heard this. Heard that it's not something that can be explained. Somebody was telling me which day, because of the week when we were sharing this thing. I said, somebody, this is that I'm telling you, which day, I don't know how they came to pass. How would I be to explain that for 3 years we were paying a low repayment to the bank that we took the facility to purchase this place for 28 million? 656,000 every month, this month, next month, this month, and it keeps on going on. And we're doing other things, breaking, doing innovation of millions. How the money was coming, I don't know. I told also somebody that, some people, I told that this KRP is beyond the ones that we see. Because there are some members that are outside this nation and they are faithfully adhering to what is happening. They pay their tithe. Even yet, I was telling you somebody that wired 1 million tithe to the account about last month from UK. Some from Abuja, they pay. From Port Harcourt, they pay. So when they are trying to see, let me even see what the secret. They don't know. Some of things I don't even see. The way things come that some people just enter the office, that I pass some people and be led to bless the church with it. This is the church that in himself he has been growing. And to say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And to say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
God has been the God of increase in this church because he has been taking us from one level of glory to another. In the book of Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18. Proverbs 4, 18. He said, the path of the just is as the shining light. He shines for more and more unto the perfect day. That is why I've always said that we have never experienced a better last year. Once upon a time, this place was looking for us. Then later, we had to overflow in the front. Then later, we are now to be getting the festival canopy, as they call it. Then later, we are now to speak to the side. Then later, we now have to take permission from our neighbor to have canopy in front. Just on and on and on. And God has been increasing us. Yet, it is not by our power, not by our mind. Because truly, what other people are trying to do to get things done, we don't do it. Yet, God has been increasing us. I pray for you. Whatever level that you are right now, by the reason of the anointing that is evidently operational in this place, let the anointing of increase come upon your life.
Amen.
It is in our services. We started with 2 services. That happened to be a wonder to some of my senior pastors. How can you be starting a parish? They are telling you to go and start a parish or that can take over 200 people. And you are starting with 2 services and they gave you less than 15 people. You didn't understand it. But God now made those 2 services to be insufficient. And we now have to move to 3 services. What are programs? We move from programs that we have regularly to Relationship Sunday, Business Sunday, Worship Service, Testimony Service. There has always been something that God will be doing. This new year now, we'll be doing so many more things. And I pray that you will benefit from it.
Amen.
I said that you will benefit from it. I was in the camp yesterday and I was going to, as a pastor, I was telling you in the course of the week that nobody in my family has been a pastor before. So I was afraid when they told me that I would be a pastor. What will I be preaching that will not finish within 1 month? But God has been faithful. God has been faithful. 3 services, some people say that, how come the 3 services? Somebody told me that he went to a particular place at Oregon, that he attended the 5 services, that is the same sermon that will be preached. Like, but pastor, when do you preach 3 services? It's always different thing. How do you do it? It's not me. It's God that has been increasing up in inspiration to deliver. And I pray that same God will lead unto you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. So there are some things that I just want to tell us. I tagged some lessons that I've learned in this 8 years as a pastor. Personal experiences based on the things that I have had to deal with, the counseling sessions I've had to do, and some of the things that have just come to conclusion that these things should be run with for a life that will succeed. I'll just run through them, system of them, then we'll pray. And we'll go to the next item. I tag you a few lessons I have learned from doing the job of a pastor in these few years. Number one, no matter how you feel, get up, dress up, show up, and never give up. With time, you will go up. No matter, some days you don't even feel like coming to church as a pastor. But at that beginning time, how will things be? No matter how you feel, get up, dress up, show up in whatever place that you're supposed to be operating, and never give up. With time, you will go up. Number two, a mighty tree grows from a small seed. Hence, pay attention to small things, because they are the things that lead to big things. A mighty tree grows from a small seed. Hence, pay attention to small things, because they are the things that lead to big things. Number three. Everything has its beauty, but not everyone sees it. So, seek to see the beauty even in ugly situations, and you will appreciate how beauty is interwoven with ugly situations. I repeat, everything has its beauty, but not everyone sees it. So, seek to see the beauty even in ugly situations, and you will appreciate how beauty is interwoven with ugly situations. Number four. In school, we were taught that mistakes are bad. But if you take time to ponder on the way we all learn to stand, to walk, and to run, we learned through falling down severally. If we never fail, we will never walk. So if you fall, get up again. You will walk someday if you refuse to stay falling. I'll repeat that. In school, we were taught that mistakes are bad. But if you take time to ponder on the way we all learn to stand, to walk, to run in life, we learn to falling down severally. If we never fail, we will never walk. So if you fall, get up again. You will walk someday if you refuse to stay falling. Number five. There is no one in life that does not go through periods of challenges. But the difference between the winners and the losers is that the winners turn their obstacles to opportunities that defy the negative obstacles. There is no one in life that does not go through periods of challenges. But the difference between the winner and the loser is that the winners turn their obstacles to opportunities that will defy the negativity of that obstacle. Number six, you got to think about big things while doing small things, so that all the small things you do will go into the big picture you thought about. I repeat. You've got to think about big things while doing small things, so that all the small things you do will go into the big picture you talked about. Number seven. Endeavor to regularly be in the presence of people that are dreamers, doers, believers, thinkers, but most of all, people that see greatness in you, even when you don't see it in yourself. This wakes up the sleeping giant in you, I repeat. Endeavor to regularly be in the presence of people that are dreamers, doers, believers, thinkers, and most of all, people that see greatness in you, even when you don't see it in yourself. This will wake up the sleeping giant in you. Number 8. The strongest people are not those who show strength in front of us, but those who fight and win battles we know nothing about. Seek not just to win open battles, but also to have unseen victories. I repeat. The strongest people are not those who show strength in front of us, but those who fight and win battles we know nothing about. Seek not just to win open battles, but also to have unseen victory. Number 9. Sometimes you don't realize the strength you have developed until you come face to face with your greatest weakness again. So even when it doesn't appear that you are adding any ounce, keep working on yourself. The unseen will show up when need arises sooner or later. And again, sometimes you don't realize the strength you have developed until you come face to face with your greatest weakness again. So even when it doesn't appear that you are adding any ounce, keep working on yourself. The unseen will show up when the need arises sooner or later. Number 10 out of 16. Where you are headed is far more important than how fast you are going. I repeat. Where you are headed is far more important than how fast you are going. Because some people are full speed to the wrong place. And people, the world is fighting for them for their speed. But they are going to the wrong direction. So get your compass right, please set. And keep moving in the right direction. You'll get there someday. Number 11. No experience is ever wasted. Everything has a lesson. Don't waste the experience. Learn from the lesson it has to offer and be better for it. I repeat. No experience is ever wasted. Even painful one, disappointing one. Everything has a lesson. Don't waste the experience that happened to you, that taught you. What are you to learn from it? Learn from the lesson it has so far and be better for it. Number 12. One of the greatest gifts you can give to anyone is the gift of attention. I've come to realize this few years. One of the greatest gifts you can give to anyone is the gift of attention. Number 13. The major difference between a good day and a bad day is your attitude. The major difference between a good day and a bad day is your attitude. Number 14 out of 16. One language everyone can relate with, regardless of where they are from, is the language of a smile. Speak that language often. I repeat, one language everyone can relate with, regardless of where they are from, is the language of a smile. Speak that language often. Number 15. When you feel your temper rise, as I do at times, pray. When thought creeps up on you, as I feel again, pray. When disappointment seems to pull you down, pray. Prayer never fails to lift you up instantaneously, gradually, or eventually, I repeat that, when you feel your temper rise, pray. When hurt creeps up on you, pray. When disappointment seems to pull you down, pray. Prayer never fails to lift you up instantaneously, or gradually, or eventually. And the last one, what goes round comes around. Hence, keep your circle positive. Speak good words, think good thoughts, do good deeds, and that which you will mostly be receiving will be good. I repeat that. What goes around comes around. Hence, keep your circle positive. Speak good words, think good thoughts, do good deeds, and that which we mostly, I'm careful to not say that which we always become, because sometimes that can happen to those people, that which we mostly you'll be receiving will be good. Shall we bow our heads? I leave this place. Maybe you were not here when our Father in God was ministering, but this is the day that God has designed that you will have a relationship with Him. You don't need to preach so long or talk about holiness for you to know that the presence of God is in this place and God has brought you here. You might have been coming severally, no problem, but there's always a day that you have that encounter. You are tired of sin. Pastor, I am tired of this negative habit. I want to break free, but it is always dragging me down. You need a divine touch. And that divine touch starts with a decision from you. Are you willing to make that decision? Are you humble enough to say, God, without you, I cannot be willing. I need you. I have been on this side before, but I have backslidden. I need to come back to you. Wherever you are, if you are not too proud, lift up your right hand and I'll be praying for you. God bless you. Lift up your right hand. God bless you. Wherever you are, outside, lift up your right hand. Pastor, pray for me. I need a fresh touch from God. I need to have my life back from the devil. Anyone? God bless you. God bless you. Another person? Another person? God bless you. Somewhere there in the back. Just come around. God is touching people's hearts. God is telling some people outside. Okay, God bless all the people outside. Just collect the cards. Collect the cards. We are going to be praying for you right now. And this prayer will touch that thing that has been dragging you down. If you have collected the cards, can you just repeat after me and say, my Heavenly Father, I thank you for your word and your presence in this place. I am convinced that I'm supposed to fully be in your camp, but I find myself doing things I ought not to be doing at times. I need your help to live a holy life, and I am boldly asking for that help now. Please save me and deliver me from anything that is holding me down. Let my name be written afresh in the book of life. Help me to stand where I've been falling, and help me to live a holy life to the glory of your name till I see you in heaven. I thank you because I know you have heard this prayer and I know you have answered me. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Everlasting Father, I thank you for your children that have made this decision right now, wherever they are, outside and inside. Please confirm their decision with your power. Power to live a holy life. Power to say no to the things they have been saying yes to that are not right. Power to stand where they have been falling. Power to evangelize for you. And power to fulfill their destiny and see you glory. Grant this unto all of them. and let your name alone be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. God bless you. Please feed those cards and return the cards to the usher. The usher will get to us. Shall we rise to our feet and just pray this prayer and say, Father, just as you have evidently been present in this parish, let your hand rest upon my life and me, and take